Hi, I'm Susan Taylor with Scripps Health in San Diego, California. Lymphedema is swelling in your body because of a buildup of fluid in the soft tissue when the lymph system is damaged or blocked. What causes it? How do you diagnose it and treat it? Joining us is Dr. Manish Champaneria. He's a plastic surgeon with the Scripps Clinic Medical Group who specializes in lymphedema surgery, and also Maryam Ronema. She is a physical therapist, a certified lymphedema therapist at Scripps Memorial Hospital in La Jolla. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you for having us.
So tell me, what are the lymph nodes? Because they're kind of located all over the body, right? What do they do?
Lymph nodes are found all throughout the body. They're found in your neck, also your armpits, even other parts of your head and neck. They're lumps of tissue that help filter the blood and the lymphatic system. They fight infection, and they're very important to the body.
And what is the lymphatic system?
The lymphatic system is a system similar to the circulatory system, the blood system, but it's fluid that's found within the lymphatic channels, and it helps to fight infection.
And so what is lymphedema?
Lymphedema is chronic swelling from damage to the lymphatic system, either from congenital reasons or from reasons that are caused by surgery or by trauma.
Right. So what causes the lymph system to be damaged or blocked?
So oftentimes it might be a cancer operation. Patients who have had breast cancer, patients who have had prostatectomies may have chronic swelling of their armpit, of their upper extremity, also their leg. It could also happen from congenital reasons as well. There's various different diseases that can cause lymphedema.
And what would those diseases be?
Like lymphedema tarda, lymphedema praecox. Those are all different disease forms that develop over the course of one's life. Those are the congenital forms of lymphedema. Lymphedema can also be caused most commonly in the world by infection from a mosquito.
Oh, wow. Okay. Mm-hmm. And so that just causes the skin to swell.
It does, definitely.
And then that would block the lymph nodes.
Yes, it causes an obstruction in the lymphatic channels.
Oh, that's interesting. Okay. What are the symptoms of lymphedema?
You know, the most common symptom is swelling of the arm or the leg. The affected body part tends to swell and get bigger, and over time, fat gets deposited in there. So it does tend to grow over time.
And this is not something that can be reduced by, you know, putting ice on it or something?
Typically, ice doesn't help. This is an intrinsic problem with the lymphatic system, where there might be a break in the lymphatic channels or an obstruction or blockage.
And so how quickly does this swelling occur?
In some cases, it can start relatively quickly after surgery or after the inciting event. But typically, lymphedema does take some time to develop.
And how much time are you talking about? Days, weeks?
I'm talking about weeks to months to even years in certain patients.
So how do you diagnose it?
There are lots of ways to diagnose lymphedema, but the first and foremost thing is to visit with your doctor. A physical examination is the most important. As I said before, lymphedema usually presents with chronic swelling. So going in to visit your doctor is the most important. There's also other imaging that can be performed to help diagnose that as well.
And that would be what? X-ray?
X-rays typically don't work. CT scans don't typically work, but typically a MRI could also work. We also have other nuclear studies that can work as well to help diagnose lymphedema.
And so how do you treat lymphedema?
The first line therapy for lymphedema is physical therapy. Physical therapy is very important to help keep the swelling at bay. And oftentimes it helps prevent infection and the lymphedema from getting worse.
And then Maryam, talk about physical therapy.
Well, the physical therapy for lymphedema is multifaceted. We call it complete decongestive therapy, which consists of lymphatic drainage, which is a form of a massage, a very light form of massage, basically stretching the skin and enhancing the movement of the lymphatics. There's bandaging. We have also a vasopneumatic device, or a pump as we call it, which I have one here to show you.
Sure.
So this is a machine that we have. And then, for example, if it's somebody's arm, we'll put this on, then the machine on, and the different chambers will fill up with air and push more fluid out of the person. Of course, exercise is also very important, because in the superficial stages of the fluid is moved because we move. the fluid under the skin, because we move, the fluid also moves. So exercise is an important part of the whole treatment cycle.
So you encourage exercise. If somebody's swollen, don't sit in a chair or sit in bed, actually get up and move.
Absolutely. And sometimes people get swollen because they sit up, they just sit, you know. They can cause secondary lymphedema at times because people just sit a lot.
And then doctor, if it's severe, there is surgery to help correct this. Talk about that surgery.
Yeah, there definitely is surgery. The first line therapy is, of course, physical therapy. But if that doesn't work, then surgery is the answer. There are different types of surgery. The two most common are lymph node transfers, where we take lymph nodes from one part of the body and transfer it to the extremity, the limb that is affected. The other one is a bypass surgery, where we connect lymphatic channels to small veins to bypass the lymphatic system.
How fast do you get relief from this?
You know, lymphedema surgery is not a quick response. It can take several months to even years to see the effects. So patience is a virtue when it comes to lymphedema surgery.
So can lymphedema be cured? I mean, can you make it go away?
Typically, no. I tell patients that I cannot cure lymphedema, but the goal of lymphatic surgery and physical therapy is to reduce the size of the limb, to reduce the infection rate, and to improve quality of life.
And then Miriam, how do you live with lymphedema?
Well, I tell my clients that lymphedema is containable. Once they contain it and we make the limb as small as possible, then they wear a compression sleeve. They could have one of these vasopneumatic machines at home. They can look at diet, into exercising, and basically maintaining the size that we give them. So it's very, people can live with it comfortably.
And what about, doctor, keeping the skin clean and moist and not sticking a needle? Let's say you have to have a vaccine. You're not going to stick it in the arm that's swollen, right?
Yeah, you really want to take really good care of your skin as well as that that extremity. You don't want to have IVs in that limb. You don't want to have vaccinations in that limb. You really want to take extra care to keep it clean and dry and well moisturized.
And Miriam, once you have the lymphedema, how often do you do this massage therapy and the compression sleeve?
Well, once we have the client, we work with them until we get the limb as optimally small as possible. Then we teach them what to do and they carry on at home. They wear their compression sleeve, they have a machine, and then they can carry on with their own lymphatic drainage. We do all of those education with them.
Is that something that they would have to use every day?
Yes.
Doctor, when should you go see a doctor to get the swelling checked out?
It's important to see them relatively quickly. You should see your primary care physician as soon as you notice some swelling that might be associated with a recent surgery that you've had, with a recent infection, or if swelling that came out of the blue to the legs, it's important to go see your physician at that time.
And if you don't get a handle on this, if you don't get it treated, what can happen?
The limb can exponentially grow. So what happens over time is the swelling can get bigger and bigger and bigger. And over time, you can get fatty deposits on that limb too. And that's a high risk for infection. And nobody wants an infection or any serious injury to the arm or the leg or the affected body part.
Any final thoughts?
Lymphedema is an important disease, and it's important to get treated quickly and be seen by your physician quickly. Physical therapy is the mainstay of treatment, and if that fails, there is surgical options available. And it's important to get seen and important to get treated so that we can have high quality of life.
Any final thoughts, Miriam?
Yes, I think my most the message I have for everybody is that it's okay to swell. People do, after surgery or for other reasons, but it's not okay to stay swollen. So get yourself to your primary care and to us, and we'll take care of you.
Thank you both for joining us. We really appreciate you taking the time.
Thank you so much.
If you want more information on lymphedema, just click on the link or go to scripps.org/videos. Want more critical information about your health? Please subscribe to our Scripps Health YouTube channel and follow us on social media at Scripps Health. At Scripps, we're here for good. I'm Susan Taylor. Thanks for joining us.